Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'll show you how to access and use the Google Analytics demo account. It's the perfect way to explore the reports available in GA4 Google Analytics 4. You can use it whenever you need to do a walkthrough or demonstration. It's also a handy way to see some of the different configuration options in Google Analytics. Apart from showing you how to use the demo account, I'll also discuss some limitations you might encounter. Okay, let's get started. The Google Analytics demo lets you access two types of GA4 properties. There's one for a website and another for an app, so you can explore different types of data in the demo account. Okay, to access the demo account, let's head to the Google Analytics Help Center. Before you can use the Google Analytics demo account, you will need to be logged into your Google account. This could be your Gmail account or your Google Workplace account. I've already logged in and you can see I'm on the demo account page in the Google Analytics Help Center. I've included a link to this page in the description below this video. Then we need to scroll down. At the bottom of the Access Demo Account section, you'll see three outbound links. These links let you access the GA4 demo properties. The first demo property is for the Google Merchandise Store. The Google Merchandise Store is a website that sells Google-branded products, including t-shirts, mugs, and other Google merchandise. Let's take a look. You can find the merchandise store at shop.merch.google. And you can see it sells a range of Google products. So this is where the data comes from for our first GA4 demo property. Okay, let's head back to the Google Analytics Help Center. The second demo property is for the Flooded app and website. The Flooded app is a simple game that's available on Android and iOS. Let's take a look. You can find a landing page at flood-it.app. You don't need to download the app, but this page, along with the apps, is where the data comes from. Okay, let's head back to the Google Analytics Help Center again. And until mid-2024, we can also access the Universal Analytics demo property. This is for the previous version of Google Analytics. This demo property stopped processing data in mid-2023, so I wouldn't bother using this one. To access the demo, we just need to click one of these options. Let's click the demo property for the merchandise store. The GA4 demo property opens in a new tab. Now, the demo properties are a little bit strange at the moment. At the top of the interface, we would normally see the name of the account and property presented, but we can see it's blank at the moment. The other strange thing is that previously, when you accessed one of the demo properties, it was saved in your list of accounts. But at the moment, the demo account is not being saved. This means that if you close your browser or switch to a different Google Analytics property, you will need to head back to the Google Analytics Help Center and click the link to the demo property each time you want to access it. Hopefully Google fixes this, but currently, that is what you have to do whenever you want to use the demo. Okay, let's summarize the reports that are available in the demo. We're looking at the Home report, which provides a top-level overview. This includes how many users visited the website in the last 28 days, how many key events, previously called conversions, were recorded, along with the total number of events, and sessions. We can also see trends for each of these metrics compared to the previous 28 days for the selected date range. The report also includes automated insights for the data that's been collected using Google's machine learning. Now let's navigate to Reports. The report's snapshot is very similar to the Home report, but it includes some different metrics and cards. The real-time report lets you view current user activity, including the number of users in the last 30 minutes. The acquisition reports show you how people are finding the website or app. The engagement reports show you all of the events that have been collected, along with the pages or screens people viewed. The monetization reports include details about the items sold on the merchandise store. The retention report provides cohort reporting. The demo property has been linked with Google Search Console, so we can see the Search Console reports, which include details about how the website appears in organic results on Google. The user attributes reports include demographic details about your users. This includes their geographic locations and other details. You can also find audiences that have been configured in this section. The tech reports let you view details about the different devices people are using. Selecting Explore lets you create your own custom exploration reports. This is the perfect way to experiment and play with the different types of exploration reports you can create in GA4. However, you can't create user explorer reports in the demo property. This is because the report includes identifiers that can potentially be tied to individuals. Navigating to advertising lets you access attribution reports and the dedicated Google Ads reports in GA4. This is where we can find another limitation of the demo property. Depending on the date range we select, we can find some traffic coming from Google Ads campaigns. However, the traffic appears to come from Google Ads demo accounts, so the data doesn't look like what you would find coming from real Google Ads campaigns. So keep an eye out for that. While we're talking about limitations, I want to mention some other things you might find when using the demo property. There are times when the traffic drops in the reports. If we head back to the home report, we can see this. There are some days when the traffic suddenly drops. This is probably because of an issue with the implementation. There's also an unusually small amount of traffic from social networks. You'll see this if you use any of the acquisition reports. There's no option to export reports in the demo property, so you can't download a PDF or CSV version of the reports. And the monetization reports, including some of the e-commerce metrics, include incorrect data. Before we wrap up, I want to mention that while you can't adjust any of the settings for the property, you can review some of the different configuration options. Let's navigate to Admin and select Data Collection and Modification. Select Data Streams and open the data stream. We can now see the different settings selected for the data stream. This means you can check different settings and configurations that have been selected in the demo property. So that's how you can access and use the Google Analytics demo account. Remember, there are some limitations to the demo account, so I also recommend creating your own testing account to experiment with the features and reports that are not supported. If you'd like to learn more about Google Analytics, then please subscribe to this channel for all of the latest updates. And please take a moment to check out my courses. I've included a link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.